The ISBLANK function will find all the nulls or empty cells in your data set. And this is a really useful function for data analysts because often data analysts work with dirty data. That means data with missing values or wrong values. And if you pass those missing values into several of the upstream mathematical calculations, you get errors. So it's important to spot these problems at the beginning of your analytics process. I'm going to write an ISBLANK function, which will look at missing values for any one of the columns in my data set. And I'm going to start by looking at the temperature in Fahrenheit of the data. So let me add a column next to temperature Fahrenheit, which will check whether the Fahrenheit column has any missing values. And I'll call this column missing temp question mark. Double click on it to expand it. In the first cell, I'm going to write the isBlank function. The isBlank function takes one value, which is the cell that you're looking to evaluate for blanks. In this case, I'm looking at the temperature in Fahrenheit. So I'll just put H2 and then autocomplete. We can see that this is false, but if I autocomplete it to every other cell and then filter by that column, I'll be able to only look at rows where that's true. And in fact, we can see now we do have four rows where the Fahrenheit is missing. Let's look at these rows with missing Fahrenheit to see if there are any upstream errors that have been caused by these missing values being incorrectly applied. Yeah, well, I can quickly see that in the column that I created in using the if function, actually, I don't think this is working correctly. Just because the temperature is missing doesn't mean that it's okay to work. So why has this if statement not worked correctly? Well, let's think about this a little bit. The first argument, if H27 is greater than 76, evaluates to too hot if true and okay to work if false. Well, clearly, if the value is missing, then H27 is not going to evaluate to greater than 76 because there's no data. So it clearly evaluates to false, in which case we've written okay to work. And this obviously isn't quite right. Okay, so we can go ahead and change this if statement so that it pays attention to whether there's missing data before it calculates whether the temperature is too hot or not. How are we going to change the statement? Well, remember, the if statement, our first parameter is the logical test. And so all I'm going to do here is I'm going to change our logical test so that instead of looking at the temperature directly, the first thing it does is check whether there's missing data. So I'm going to write a nested function in Excel, and nested functions are something that you'll use a lot as a data analyst or a data scientist. So now I'm going to add an isBlank statement as my first parameter. This isBlank statement, which evaluates to true or false, is going to check whether the temperature field is missing or not. Now, what happens if it's missing? That's the true statement. Well, if it's missing, if it's true, then we want to bring that to the attention of the data analyst. So let's print out something like missing data, exclamation mark, exclamation mark. Now we need to work out what to do if the value is false. Well, if the value is false, we're going to go ahead and perform our original calculation. And that was by using the if statement that we looked at originally. So I can now add another if statement in here that evaluates whether it's above 76 or below 76. Now I just need to add one more closing bracket to this statement just so our opening brackets and closing brackets match. I can go ahead and complete that. And then when I auto-populate this data down, you can see that now we have in this column next to the missing values, we have missing data in exclamation mark. So let's just finish this off by adding a filter function that goes to check all the instances of missing data. Great, we've definitely captured all the instances of missing data. We're good.